Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Let me show you how you can type more than one line of text, even when it appears that you can't. So sometimes when you're typing on your Mac or even on an iPhone or iPad, it appears that you can only type one line of text. When you press the return key, it simply submits the text or goes to the next field. For instance, when you're typing a message in the Messages app, sometimes you may want to have more than one line of text in your message. Now, you could just keep typing and keep everything in one long line. But what if you really wanted to have a return or two between lines of text? For instance, say you were typing something like this. Now, your intention is to put the next word on the next line. But when you press return, which is the natural thing to do, it submits the message. So it appears that you can only have one line of text in a message. You can't put a second line because pressing return will send the message. But there is a way to do it. The trick is, instead of pressing return, hold down either the shift key or the option key, and you'll simply add a new line. For instance, here I hold shift and press return, and you see how I go to the next line. I can actually insert several blank lines by using shift and return if I like. You can also use option and return. It does the same thing. So you can put as many lines of text as you want in a single message before pressing just return by itself to send it. Now, this trick comes handy in a variety of other situations as well. For instance, here in Reminders, I'm going to add a new reminder here. I'm going to type something, and let's say I want to put a second line in the title of this reminder. If I press return, it goes to the next reminder. But instead, if I hold out option and press return, I actually get another line, and I can actually have a reminder with two lines in the title. No, it doesn't work if you do shift and return. So in the case of the Reminders app, option return works, but shift return doesn't. If you find these videos valuable, consider joining the more than 2,000 others that support MACMOST through Patreon. You get exclusive content, course discounts, and more. You can read about it at MACMOST.com/Patreon. Here's another example of a place where you can use this. Let's say I'm in the calendar app. If I were to double click in a day, if I type the name of an event like this, and I press return, it accepts it as the name of the event. But if instead I use option and return, I can actually put another line as the name of the event. Now, it's going to condense that into a single line here in the monthly view, and the same in week view and in day view. But if I were to view it, I could see multiple lines here in the title. And in this case, shift return doesn't work either, only option return. Now, you can use this sometimes in web apps, like, for instance, websites that have communities where you can chat. Very often, pressing return simply sends it like a message. If you want a second line, sometimes it shows you on the website that using either shift return or option return will get you that. For instance, here at Patreon, you can get a second line by holding the shift key down and pressing return. But holding the option key down and pressing return will actually send the message. Now, here's another place where this comes in very handy. In Numbers, you can have multiple lines of text in a cell. So if I'm typing in the cell, of course, I could just type a very long paragraph of text here. But if I want to have, you know, one line and then another line in the same cell, I need to use option and then return, and I can have a second line like that. It has to be option, not shift. And you can add as many lines as you want in a single cell. Now, this even works in formulas. It'll ignore the new lines. So you can have your formulas be a little bit more readable by breaking them up into lines. I just pressed equals there to start a new formula, and I'll start it like this. And let's say I want to put the next part of this formula on a new line. I can do option return, go to a new line, and I can then have this next part right here. It's going to ignore that new line there and give me the correct answer. This also comes in handy when you want to have a result that's multiple lines. So for instance, here, I can have some text like this in the double quotes, put an ampersand, and then I could have a calculation like that. And then let's say I want to have a second part of the result here, I can do ampersand again, a double quote, and then option return to go to a new line. And that's part of the text inside the double quotes. So now I can continue like this. and have a second part like that. And you could see that option return is here inside double quote just before the B equals portion. And you could see how it does these two calculations, puts them on separate lines because of the option return that I placed right here. So the next time you're in a situation in an app or on a web page where pressing return seems to send or complete the text entry, try option return or shift return on your Mac, and then you can have multiple lines of text instead of a single long line. Now, sometimes you need to do this on the iPhone or iPad as well, but it's rarer because the virtual keyboard allows you to have other buttons on the screen. So the return key can actually act as a new line, and there could be a separate button for send or complete. Sometimes this is an upward pointing arrow. But then if you're using a physical keyboard, like on an iPad with a Magic Keyboard, the shift return or option return sometimes works as well. And in a rare case where the return key does actually send something on an iPhone or iPad, you can tap the shift key first. And then once that's highlighted, it's a solid up arrow instead of an outline. Then pressing return will be the same as doing shift return. And in some cases, will get you a second line instead of sending the text.